Om Namah Shivaya. Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om.
Nandikeshwara said, Mahadev then created a wonderful person named Bhairava from the middle of his brows to quell the pride of Brahmā. This Bhairava knelt before the Lord in the battlefield and said, O Lord, what shall I do? Please give me your directive quickly. Shiva said sarcastically, Dear, here is Brahmā, the first deity of the universe. Worship him with your sharp-pointed, quick-moving sword. Immediately, Bhairava caught hold of the śikhā of Brahmā's fifth head that was guilty of haughtily uttering a falsehood, and furiously shook his sword to cut it off. Your father trembled like a plantain tree in a whirlwind, with his ornaments scattered here and there, his cloth ruffled and loosened, his garland displaced, the upper cloth hanging loose, and the glossy śikhā dishevelled, and fell at the feet of Bhairava. Meanwhile, the sympathetic Achyuta, desirous of saving Brahmā, shed tears over the lotus-like feet of our Lord and said with palms joined in reverence, just like a child lisping words of entreaty to its father. Achyuta said, O Lord, it was you who gave him five heads as a special symbol long ago. Hence, please forgive him his first guilt. Please favor him. The Lord, thus requested by Achyuta, relented, and in the presence of all devas asked Bhairava to desist from punishing Brahmā. Then the Lord turned to the deceitful Brahmā, who bent down his neck, and said, O Brahmā, in order to extort honor from the people, you assumed the role of the Lord in a roguish manner. Hence you shall not be honored, nor shall you have your own temple or festival. Brahmā said, O Lord, be pleased. O flourishing one, I consider your sparing my head itself a great blessing and a boon. Obeisance to thee, the Lord, kinsman of all, the originator of the universe, the forbearing, the forgiver of defects, the benevolent one wielding the mountain as his bow. Ishvara said, O child, the whole universe will be ruined if it loses the fear of the king. Hence, you mete out punishment to the guilty and bear the burden of administering this universe. I shall grant you another boon, which is very difficult to get. In all domestic and public sacrifices, you will be the presiding deity. Even though a sacrifice is complete with all the ancillary rites and offerings of monetary gifts, it will be fruitless without you. Then the Lord turned to the deceitful Kaitaki flower, guilty of perjury, and said, O you, Kaitaki flower, you are roguish and deceitful. Go away from here. Hereafter, I have no desire to include you in my worship. When the Lord said thus, all the devas shunned the very presence of that flower. Kaitaka said, Obeisance to thee, O Lord, your bidding will mean that my very birth is fruitless. May the Lord be pleased to make it fruitful by forgiving my sin. Thy remembrance is reputed to quell all sins perpetrated consciously or unconsciously. Now that I have seen thee, how can the sin of uttering falsehood sully me? Thus entreated in the middle of the council, the Lord said, It is not proper for me to wear you. I am the Lord, and my words must remain true. My attendants and followers shall wear thee. Hence thy birth shall be fruitful. Of course, in the canopies over my idol you can be used for decoration. The Lord thus blessed the three, the flower Kaitaki, Brahmā, and Vishnu. He shone in the assembly, duly eulogized by the devas.